Hello, and welcome to TI Precision Lab series covering voltage reference considerations for SAR ADCs. The goal of this section is to give a general overview of the SAR ADC internal circuitry. In particular, we will focus on the capacitive DAC, or called CDAC. Understanding the CDAC will show us the mechanism that creates the current transients on the reference input of SAR ADCs. Here we have the addenda for the entire reference series. In this section, the internal capacitive digital to analog converter, or CDAC, and comparator block functionality is covered, and an explanation of the SAR reference input behavior is presented. Let's get started. A SAR data converter conversion cycle can be broken into two different phases, the acquisition phase and the conversion phase. During the acquisition phase, the external driving circuit charges the converter's internal sample and hold capacitor to a voltage equal to the amplifier's output voltage. Switch S1 is closed at the beginning of the acquisition phase, and switch S1 opens at the end of the acquisition phase when the conversion process starts. The plot at the right shows the sample and hold voltage as it charges to the target voltage during the acquisition period. This slide shows the conversion phase. At the start of the conversion phase, the switch S1 opens and the input voltage is stored on the sample and hold capacitor. In this example, you can see that 2.6 volts is stored on the sample and hold capacitor. The SAR ADC operates by using a binary search algorithm to converge to the input signal. At the heart of the SAR ADC architecture, the capacitive DAC, or CDAC, generates binary weighted voltages as a function of the reference input, and a high-speed comparator is used to perform the bit decisions. In this example, we cover a 5-bit converter, so 5 comparisons will be done starting with the most significant bit, or MSB, and moving to the least significant bit, or LSB. The SAR ADC converter performs a bit decision every conversion clock cycle, where the CDAC sets a binary weighted voltage at the input of the comparator. The plot at the right shows the binary weighted CDAC voltages as the binary search algorithm converges to the input voltage. Next, we will show the internal CDAC circuit and provide an overview of how it functions. This overview will give a better insight into the origin of the current transients generated at the ADC reference input. Here, we show the internal circuit of the CDAC. The CDAC consists of an array of N capacitors with binary weighted values plus one additional LSB capacitor. This example shows a 5-bit SAR ADC converter. All capacitors have binary weighted values, C, C over 2, C over 4, to the least significant weight of C over 16. The last two capacitors having the value of C over 16 are connected so that the total parallel capacitance of the capacitor array is 2 times C. The conversion process starts with the acquisition phase, where switch SA is closed and switch SB is connected to the input voltage of plus 2.6 volts. The input voltage VIN is applied at the ADC input, and a total charge of Q equals to negative 2 times C times VIN is stored in the capacitor array. The equivalent figure at the right shows a simplification of the input circuit. To reiterate, the capacitance 2 times C is the parallel combination of all the conversion capacitors. The input voltage is applied directly across the capacitor 2 times C, and the charge negative 2 times C times VIN is stored. After the acquisition phase ends, the conversion phase starts with the hold mode. During the hold mode, switch SA opens, and all binary weighted capacitor switches S1 to S5 prime are connected to ground, resulting in a voltage of VC equals to negative 2.6 volts at the comparator input. Notice the voltage is inverted, since the opposite side of the binary weighted capacitor is now grounded. Switch SB disconnects from the input pin and connects to the reference voltage input. Again, look at the figure on the right for a simplified view of the circuit. The conversion process is performed by charge redistribution. The conversion sequence starts with the most significant bit, or MSB decision. During this step, switch S1 connects the largest capacitor, C, to the reference voltage, VREF. Capacitor C forms a 101 capacitance divider with the rest of the binary weighted capacitor. The simplified circuit on the right shows the comparator voltage becomes VC equals to negative VN plus VREF over 2, or VC equals to negative 0.552 volts. Since the voltage at the inverting comparator input is negative, the comparator output goes high, providing the most significant bit decision, MSB equal to 1. Notice that the reference input sees an effective switch capacitance load of C over 2 when the MSB decision is made. This capacitive load will cause a rapid transient current spike when it is connected. The conversion process continues with the MSB minus 1 decision. The second bit decision step connects C over 2 to VREF using switch S2. Since the first bit decision step resulted in MSB equal to 1, switch S1 is turned to ground, again to discharge C. Capacitor C over 2 forms a 3-4 capacitance divider with the rest of the binary weighted capacitor as shown on the simplified circuit on the right. The comparator voltage becomes VC equals to negative VN plus 3/4 times VREF. The resulting voltage at the inverting comparator input is positive, and the comparator output goes low, providing the second bit decision, MSB minus 1, equal to 0. During the third bit decision, C over 4 connects to VREF using switch S3. Since the previous bit decision step was 0, switch S2 is left connected to VREF. The parallel combination of capacitors C over 4 and C over 2 form a 5-to-8 capacitance divider with the rest of the binary weighted capacitor, as shown on the simplified circuit on the right. The resulting voltage at the inverting comparator input is negative, and the comparator output goes high, resulting on the third bit decision equal to 1. In a similar fashion, during the fourth bit decision, C over 8 connects to VREF using switch S4. Since the last bit decision step was high, switch S3 is turned to ground, again to discharge C over 4. The simplified circuit on the right shows the comparator voltage becomes VC equals to negative VN plus 11 over 16 times VREF. The resulting voltage at the inverting comparator input is positive, and the comparator output goes low, resulting in the fourth bit decision equal to 0. At the last step, the least significant bit, or LSB, or fifth bit decision, is made by switching in C over 16, using switch S5 as shown in the circuit. The resulting 5-bit conversion result is 1, 0, 1, 0, 0. During the conversion phase, the reference input sees a dynamic switch capacitance load, as the binary weighted bit decisions are made during each conversion clock cycle. Note, the reference input voltage must remain stable as the binary weighted capacitor array is charged. It is important to highlight the worst case dynamic current transients tend to occur during the most significant bit decisions, when the largest capacitor values are switching. On the SAR ADC architecture, the reference input is sampled several times during the conversion phase. The reference is sampled once for every binary weighted bit decision during each conversion clock cycle. This plot shows the reference current transient seen at the reference input of the ADS8028, a 12-bit ADC. As the conversion process starts, a large initial current transient occurs, followed by 12 current transients for every bit decision. Although the average current consumption of the reference input may only be in the range of a few hundreds of microamps, the fast current transients occurring at this pin may be tens of milliamps in magnitude. The current transients occur every conversion clock cycle as the binary weighted conversion results are made. In a typical SAR ADC, the conversion clock frequency is in the range of tens of megahertz, and the fast current transient pulses are only a few nanoseconds away from each other. This is the reason the reference drive circuit requires a relatively large bypass capacitor to restore charge to the binary weighted capacitor array, and the reference driver circuit must be capable of driving the dynamic capacitive load while keeping the reference input stable. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Please try the quiz to check your understanding of this video's content.